Alright everybody, this is Psychedelic Eyeball, and today we're gonna be doing some grim state of affairs today, because, well, unfortunately today it has been reported that the founder of Commodore International, Jack Tramiel, has unfortunately died at the age of 83 years old. And, well, the Commodore 64 was kind of a huge deal to me, because back when I was a little kid, I always grew onto all of these little games over here. I'm not sure you're going to be able to see them, because I'm not sure my recording program even catches them, but you will see them in due time. So, in order to render an homage to this fine guy who brought a first computer in which it was possible to play a whole lot of games and everything, we're going to be playing some of them. But those of you who have watched my Super Meat World videos unfortunately know that, well, I have a tendency to just stick with the utterly horrible, so yeah, this is what we're gonna do, because, yeah, it's not gonna be a Psychedelic Eyeball video if I'm not playing a whole bunch of stuff. So yeah, we're gonna play Bionic Granny, because this sounds like such a fitting way in order to start off this little performance here. And we're gonna read the awesome text here, which is full of grammar here, errors, and yeah, U/R Bionic Granny and R waiting outside to hit the kid's ass leave. Yeah, not only the grammar is horrible into this text, but yeah, the aim of this game is to hit kids. Yeah, and dodging lollipops. So yeah, complex game. We have two keys to press. So yeah, Bionic Granny. Wasn't this a great game, ladies and gentlemen? Yeah, that's the whole game right here. You have to dodge lollipops. And why is she even bionic? I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's because she has awful frames of animation, but yeah. As you can tell, I am a bionic granny expert. Ah, Jesus Christ, I wish to get away from this game. And I always like this one person over here which clips through the wall. And the spirit of Spider-Man abits us, because what the hell? And yeah, I really like this one kid which just takes his sweet time and just go through the road. Haha, I'm coming for you, or no, come to me. Oh, are you telling me that there's more than 100 levels of this? Why is there level 001? But all right, one more game, because I hate myself today. Oh my god, this is such a horrible game. A horrible game for horrible people. Oh my god. Yeah, alright, come on. I want to die already! Ah, thank god. Okay, that was Bionic Granny, ladies and gentlemen. Wasn't that a great game? But don't you worry, there's gonna be plenty of other games. Yeah, it's fitting. Fittingly enough, I'm gonna cover a whole lot of the Mastertronic 199 series, or whatever they were called. Basically, there were a whole bunch of low-budget games published by Mastertronics. They were made by two guys, I think Richard Darling and another guy. I'm pretty sure we're gonna see his name through the full video and all of this. So we're gonna play BMX Racer. Yeah, what is it with old grannies and with these games? Really, did the grandmother of the designer of this game just decided to ruin his childhood or something? But oh my god, yeah, this is gonna be an awesome game. Yeah, you have an accelerate and brake button, but as you can tell, it doesn't really do anything when the game is auto-scrolling. Okay, and I managed to clip through a car. Oh, and I've been vanquished by the evil BMX driver. What the Are they shooting guns at you? Or is it... And yeah, by the way, whenever you run into an oil slick, whenever you're running your bicycle into this tiny road like this, well, don't you... Yeah. Oh my god. Yeah. I know I'm sucking really bad right now, but every time I see this granny, I'm just... Come on! What the hell is that? I hit this jump ramp straight ahead, and yet I died. And yeah, by the way, I didn't even press anything. The game just decided to force me into this direction. Ah, oh god. I thought for 1 second I managed to jump over the bionic granny. Yeah, in fact, the granny into this game is more of a bionic granny than the one into the other game. So yeah, color me confused. Alright, one last game, because I want... oh my god. I want to see if there's more than one level of this, because I played through this game a whole lot. No, not a whole lot, but I mean, I booted this game quite a few times. Yeah, what the f- She's not wearing any clothing whatsoever. This game is fucked up. Oh my god, yeah, the Commodore 64, ladies and gentlemen. It was all about old crannies and... yeah, and dying by hitting the jump ramp sideways. Although, to be fair, that kind of makes a little more sense than hitting it straight on and dying. And yeah, you also gotta appreciate the complex music of all of those... Yeah, that bicycle, by the way, went right through a truck, and... oh my god, I died once again by hitting this jump ramp... okay. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna make any progress into this game today, so... yeah, this game was so bad that, in some way, they made another version of it, which has exactly the same name. And I'm pretty sure that into this one version, the creators of the game actually signed it. Oh yeah, David and Richard Darling. Yeah, I forgot the first name. And yeah... the many hazards! And yeah, by the way, the many hazards that whenever you're riding a bicycle is swimming pools. And yeah, what is it with Hoy Patch? Don't ride into anything and you may become a champion. Wait. If I don't ride into anything, will that mean that, well, I actually will be riding? And yeah, by the way, this is already way more of a game than the other game that there is. And yeah, by the way, this is supposed to be a swimming pool. Isn't that nice? Although, contrary to the other game that we've seen, yeah, this one, however, even though this is already way more of a game than everything we've seen so far, yeah, into this game, you only have one life. And basically, if you manage to get far into this game for some reason, although, to be fair, like I said, this is way better than the other games, although... well, this is not saying much, but yeah, baby steps, baby steps. And maybe later into this video, I'm gonna play games that actually matter. Oh my god! And yeah, that's another stained mark of the Commodore 64, giving people seizures and making you explode into Netherlands. So, alright, we're gonna play a whole bunch of these games because, well, why not? How I wish I could simply be playing this game, but nah. We're not gonna slumber to this kind of... oh yeah, I think this one game also was done by Mastertronic, so I gotta go through it. And you also gotta... oh great, it's got a trainer too. Unlimited lives, of course. No, because I actually want to... what the hell? I died just by starting the game? And yeah, by the way, this is Vancouver. So, yeah, we gotta take this into heed for all of the people out there who are thinking that the Canucks have a chance of winning the Stanley Cup. This is what I'm doing to your city, you headends! Because supposedly the Canucks are now a hated team for some reason. I guess it's because they didn't manage to win last year or something, when they probably should have won. And yeah, by the way, you cannot go up or down into this game. You can only go sideways, and your bombs also sometimes tend to disappear into Netherlands, so... yeah, this is what I'm doing to the city, and yeah. By the way, this is what the city of Vancouver looks like, with all of the missiles that hit the crew. Oh, and yeah, by the way, I just died by touching an explosion, which was exploding. Yeah. Missiles do not need to simply land or just collide with you. No, they just need to explode near your ship, and whenever you're riding into the sprite, well, you will die. And yeah, believe it or not, this was a game that I actually played quite a bit back when I was a kid. I didn't really think of it too much, and well... it, my opinion about this game didn't really change, because yeah, this is really not much of a... yeah, and my bombs just went straight to the whole thing. Just in order to showcase how much of a great game this is. Haha, take that, you environmentalist! I'm gonna nuke all of your trees, one by one! And it would be nice if I had any way to gain altitude. Come on, there must be something that I've missed. Oh, at least this time I didn't die. Vancouver City, here we come! Do you want to see the vacation of your dreams? This is exactly what you'll be doing for this entire time. Oh my god. Yeah. Oh, Vancouver, you deserve such a better fate. Take that, you lamppost! You will never light the city anymore! Paris is not the city of the lights anymore, it's Vancouver! But I knew the only light that the city had! Oh my god, this game bites. But is there a way to progress through this? I really gotta know that. Oh, I made it to Seattle! Yeah, that's a great job on the naming there. So yeah, remember, the only way to progress through cities is to flying at such a low altitude that eventually your pilot will finally decide to wake up from its lumbering coma and will finally be, oh yeah, I'm supposed to be flying up in order to get this plane going. So sorry folks, I'm gonna lead you passenger to your flight as advertised, and we're gonna go into another scenic city. Which city could it be again? Because yeah. Okay, so I was thinking for a second that we were gonna stick to the West Coast or something, but no. Wait, that's not Mexico City at all. Come on, these people don't have buildings. Okay, or maybe they do, but not in my Challenger! That's right! Wow, this... Really, is there any change to the gameplay in all of this? I know that Commodore 64 games are not reputed to be... I'm flying solo that at one point I'm simply gonna hit a building and die. Brasilia! We're gonna tour the entirety of this world! Wait, how the hell did I manage to get more points earlier? Even though I only had 2 lives and I went only at Vancouver. Yeah, at this point I figure we're gonna stick with an endurance run of Challenger, a fine game by Mastertronic that I'm pretty sure that about 3 or 4 people played. Because yeah, it's interesting to know that, well, this entire game is based around luck, because yeah, if there are missiles in... Yeah, come on, what the hell could I do here? The building was way too tall for my plane to go over it, and well, my pilot is too stupid to gain altitude. So I really don't know what's the criteria that you have to go through in order to advance stages, because well, if you have to reach an arbitrary end of the level in order to actually make it to the new place that you have to go, well, this is not a very good game. But then again, as far as I know, this game only costs about £3, so we can't really hold it. Okay, so we went into the outer end here. We went from Canada to the United States to Tokyo. And yeah, by the way, I'm gonna play until all of my lives are gone. I'm deciding to have fun with this game, damn it! Yeah, this is me having fun right now. Look at the very involving gameplay. Well, the gameplay is involving until that eventually there's a missile that flies out and there's absolutely nothing you have to do. And yeah, by the way, this game introduced cutscenes for the first time. That's basically the huge effort that Challenger did to the video game industry. But yeah, I'm really thinking that the end of all of all is really arbitrary, because, well, every single time that I've managed to make it to a new stage, well, I basically was such as a low altitude that basically the second that something else will spawn, I will be dead. And okay, can you handle it all, please? Well, I think that the game is ending right here. Oh boy, Challenger, ladies and gentlemen. Ah, finally, a fine game that wasn't made by Mastertronic. We're gonna play Chuck Norris. And yeah, basically this gibberish at the bottom is a symbolic thing about the game. Unlimited time. Oh yes, we have all time in the world. And yeah, it's interesting to know that this is a game that was ported for several other consoles, but yeah, basically, okay. How do I start this game, ladies and gentlemen? Here I am! Oh, it's like... Okay. But how exactly do I do anything here? Okay, so come on. Ah! Oh, I finally found out. Yeah. The patented Chuck Norris sponge, ladies and gentlemen. And yeah, by the way, yeah, it's almost impossible to hit any enemy before they... Oh my... Right, hit it, you bitch! Yes! And yeah, by the way, this is such a panorama for the ages. Oh my god. If only there was a... And yeah, by the way, what is this even supposed to be? Basically, there's only two buttons. In order to attack into this game, you have to press the fire button and then up or down. But as you can tell, the moment that... Yeah, come on, I kicked this guy in the face. And the sad thing is I actually remember actually making it quite some way into this game. But yeah, come on, I punched him again, but you've seen... Oh my... And besides, how do you even get defeated? Why do you even try to kill those guys? Because, yeah, oh, holy shit, I've made it to an encounter! Okay. Alright, I'm making it through the obstacle, because, yeah, for some reason... Yeah, and we even have a real-time clock. And now we're fighting into a dojo, oh boy. Okay. So I suppose that since this pad didn't work out... wait, I wonder, can I actually... Yeah, that's the power of Chuck Norris! He can climb through mountains and... Oh god. I'm not gonna slumber into this field anymore. Oh my god. Just come back here! Why are you such a crappy fighter? Oh my god. It's time to get hurt and go back into your bed. Nah, fuck this. I really cannot take that anymore. Wait, what is cliffhanger? Oh no, wait, that's a good game, and basically we cannot stand for that. Oh yeah, I think I remember this game being really good too. We're gonna play Dark Star now. And if my memories... Oh yeah! My memory served me right. It's another Mastertronic masterpiece. You are on a suicide mission! Yeah, basically this is what playing any game by Mastertronic is. Okay. Don't fly into anything and watch out for enemy guard ships. I'll do whatever I want. And no, I'm not cheating. So yeah, we have to shoot bottles and... TIE Fighter rejects, and why the hell did I start with 7 million five? Okay, for some reason I had a shitload of points, but I don't really know why. So yeah, all right, we're destroying sphincters and laser. And yeah, by the way, this game has branching paths, just in order to showcase how highly evolved this game is, and oh my god. Yeah, I haven't played this game in quite a while, and I'm pretty sure that all of you will understand why, but... Hey, at least you cannot accuse this game of being predictable. I mean, at least... Well, the pathing and all of this is always the same, but at least the monsters seem random, so... They did somewhat of a job to make it any interesting to play, but... Yeah, what the hell is this even supposed to be? Like, yeah, by the way, if you know this, the right path, even though it was so long and utterly drawn out and sketched out, yeah, it was a dead end, but thankfully this one is slightly more predictable to see, but... Yeah, eventually this is a story of going through these empty hallways, shooting that one enemy that comes into the place, every once in a while, and then hoping that well, your steering abilities will actually make you go through this. Double Dragon, wasn't that Donkey Kong? No, come on, we cannot stand for this. Oh, we're gonna play Droll, although I'm not sure if that game was actually bad or if it was just something that I just badly recall, but I don't know. Oh boy. We have high-tech graphics here, but nah, for some reason, I don't think I remember this game being too bad. Yeah, I mean, you're a robot on a jetpack. I mean, this is everything that a game needs. And yeah, flying scorpions. Yeah, I think that what you needed to do here is... Nah, I really don't remember what this game is. Oh my god. Oh yeah, I think you needed to find the lizard or the other thing, but yeah. I really don't remember this game that well anymore. After all, isn't... Oh yeah, the dying to this game was kind of decent, yeah. This game wasn't all that bad, I gotta say. Oh, okay, I'm right here. It's dinner time! Oops. Oh my god. So, yeah, what the... Ah, here it is. I need to catch this lizard in order to finally finish the level, but... Ah, Jesus Christ, he's too fast, he's too fast. Alright, we're gonna surprise him. We're gonna go right over this place, and he's never gonna stand a chance. But, yeah, I remember sort of this game, and... Ah, Jesus Christ. Oh boy, this is level 1. Just imagine how things are gonna fare later into the game. Yeah, this lizard is seemingly trying to... Oh my god! And for once... oh, holy shit, I still have a life. So, yeah, I figured that I might as well try and finish this level because, yeah, come on. We're gonna vanquish Droll, at least the first level. Because I remember the later levels having more devious traps. For instance, you will go into stuff like this and then there will be like a man or robot eating plant, which will simply kill you. Oh my god. This lizard is so hard to catch. I really don't remember how the hell I did anything into this game when I was a kid, because it's quite harder than I remember. But I think that what you have to do is to stand around one of these things, and basically you're just hoping that the thing will eventually come into the place that you have to go. But yeah, right now I'm having the poorest of luck right now, so alright, come on. Here we go! And the game just crashed, or at least I think it did. But just in case it didn't, here's a magnificent magnetoscreen for you. Yeah, I think that's droll, ladies and gentlemen. I remember that I had all sorts of problems running this game, even back in the time. Oh, Dungeons of Dr. Creep, that was such a great game. Oh, the heist. This game always tended to confuse me back when I was a kid because, well, I don't remember exactly what the funding game that influenced that was, but yeah, I remember this game being based on something. Oh, wait, that's a demo. We're not here to see the demo, we're here to see me play. And yeah, by the way, if you just noticed, basically... shit, I missed the jump. And I also remember that you could permanently stuck yourself into this game. Alright, come on. Ah, here we go. Riding backwards. This is what my destiny for this game... Oh my god. My jumping abilities need some work. Oh yeah, I remember this game. You have to jump over toasters? And they're really hard as hell to jump because your character has the poorest jump ever. So basically, you have to jump into the toaster. Oh my god. And that was the ending of this attempt to robbing this shopping mall, which is infested with toasters and burning things. Basically, the aim of this game was to find all of the portraits and all of this. And yeah. Basically, that was the one thing which confused me, the elevators, because in order to use them, I think I remember that you needed to use... What did you have to do again in order to make that work? Ah, here we go. Yeah, you had to press the numbers on the keypad. Otherwise, they didn't work. So basically, you needed the keyboard in order to be able to even play this game. Oh shit. I have to jump over a toaster. Praise my lord. Thank you. We're here and we're gonna do a great job today. So, oh my god, I missed the jump again. But yeah, that's okay because I need some more keys. Or I need that! Yes, I've got everything that I was here for, including my incompetence. Oh my god. So yeah, that was heist, ladies and gentlemen. But at least this wasn't a bad game. Yeah, it's really rustic, but at least it works. But will this game work? Intergalactic Cage Match. This game features the best music that you'll ever hear into a Commodore 64 game. No, that's not the music, that's just the trainer, because, yeah, when you're downloading ROMs, all that you get is crack copies of games instead of having the unaltered version. And as far as I know, I don't think my Commodore 64 even works, or if there is even a way that I can record from them, but yeah, that was the awesome loading screen. Hulk Hogan against the Martians. Holy shit. And yeah, by the way, yeah, whenever that you're changing a character, the entire game reloads. So yeah, we're gonna play against a demonic ant. And yeah, don't worry, we're gonna hear some more music. Okay, so I need to wait, how do I start? Oh, yes, wait. Oh great. I didn't actually press the... Wait, okay, okay. Player 1, player 2, computer. We're gonna play against the computer and... Wait, okay. Okay, how did that game work again? I completely forgot. Face the opposition, you moron! Okay, that was needlessly graphic. And yeah, by the way, this is the... it's really hard to figure out how this game works, but yeah, you have to climb on top of the cage in order to activate a dark hole or black hole, which sucks your opponent in. Basically, this is a wrestling game in which there's practically no wrestling, because the one thing that you have to do in order to win is basically... that's all that you have to do in order to win against the computer. This is such a brilliant game. Instead of calling this Intergalactic Cage Match, they should just be calling that Intergalactic Climbing of the Wires. Take that, you hand! Oh my god, once again we're getting into... Oh my god! Try playing this game, the controls are awful. Oh my god. And as far as I remember... Wait, was there even a way to shake them off? No, there's none! Oh, that game was so wonderful. I only need to remember what I need to do as a fighter to actually do any damage on this guy, because I remember this game having extraordinary... wait, why did I get hurt? Oh my gosh. And... punch to the right, you moron! How do I... Oh god! Oh my... Alright. I need to win this! Oh my... Yeah, that's enough of this game. So, I suppose that we're gonna have to take a relief by going into the best jungle game to be ever made. Jungle Story, ladies and gentlemen, featuring once again your lords from Mastertronic. Yeah, remember Jungle Story and how we had Mowgli, which was which was risen around all of the lions and all of this, and how we always had this, that outfit and all of this. But yeah, this is how it's been represented into this game. Jungle Story! Oh yeah, that's right, it has to load, and yeah, we have wonderful loading which is going on right here. Or maybe I need... No. I'm running into place! Oh my god! And yeah, is this monkey up here just grabbing his boobs and tossing them at me? What is going on? And why am I throwing coconuts and people? And who's shooting arrows at me? And yeah, yeah. And by the way, this is how you die. By the way, the neck doesn't follow the head, or whatever. Yeah. Basically, the aim of this game is to kill all of the cheetahs that are at you by throwing them coconuts that have... Yeah, by the way, that's supposed to be fire, but yeah, I don't believe them one second, and oh, I evade that. I am an expert Jungle Story player, mind you. And yeah, I'm walking into the air, by the way. Woohoohoo! Uh-oh. You know this, that one expression which says that you shall never ride an elephant, that you'll miss an elephant into a barn? Well, don't worry, I can't do that. Come on, I need to showcase at least this one thing into the game which makes it even better. Yeah, dying animals kill you! Take that, you man cub! And that's pretty much it, and oh yeah, knockout. This is supposed to be a two-player game, but as I'm going to show you, you'll never find a second player which is gonna volunteer to even play this game. Yeah, this is a boxing game, and basically, there's two punches into this one game. Yeah, you can either punch to the belly or punch to the head. And knowing that this game has been coded in the most half-assed way possible... Oh. Yeah, I'm sorry, I had to shut up for 1 second in order to highlight this awesome musical and also the rendering of the image. Boxers! Yes, and by the way, yeah, this is why you don't want to play this game with two players, because here's the entirety of a game of knockout. Yep, an 11 second boxing contest, even though I wasted about 5 of them explaining what the game was even was. And the crowd goes wild after the worst boxing match to ever take place into history. And yeah, by the way, a white font with a white background. That's certainly a great idea, so yeah, I'm not gonna suggest you to that anymore. Oh yeah, another two-player only game, but yeah, this is one... Yeah, that game was made in 1990. Years after the Commodore 64 was no longer relevant, and... Yeah, basically, this is a laser game, and that's what you have to do. You have all sorts of tactics, like doing this, and yeah, and doing that as well, and basically, there's virtually no tactics, because yeah, you do the damage continuously, so, alright, we're gonna have an epic fight. Who's gonna win? Green one! Hell yeah! So yeah, that was the entire game. Oh my god. So yeah, we're gonna take a break from all of this crap, and we're gonna play a good game! Nah, I'm just kidding, it's a Mastertronic game with no name! And I'm Haladin with no D. And yeah, a cave with an elevator, here it is necessary to And by the way, yeah, nobody ever saw what the third cave was like, because nobody could figure out how to go through any of the... And yeah, by the way, this is how you die into this game. And besides, what is this? Am I dodging Planet Hurt or something? Oh god. Yeah, if this is the first cave, I don't want to see what the other caves of the game even look like. And by the way, this entire game is all about very strict pixel precision, because, yeah... Just look at how narrow this hallway is, and how this thing here takes all of the place. And yeah, by the way, oh yeah, actually, I was wrong. You can actually hug the... Wait, can you hug the walls or not? What is the logic behind this game? I don't know. Oh, and by the way, Yeah, this is how you do an expert speedrun in order to get a high score. Yeah, I got better score by doing this instead of going through the game legitimately, because yeah, instead of a game making you earn points by progressing through it, yeah, you get points simply by doing nothing. But, well, you start at 5,000 points, but yeah, in order to... yeah, we get a whole bunch of points, but you lose more points, and yeah, that's the treacherous elevator they talk about, and yeah, we have a whole bunch of birds that can flap or... oh god, yeah, I remember this elevator being a bitch. Oh my... Come on, just ride the elevator! Oh my god, I'm surprised from behind. Alright, come on, we're gonna get over there. Oh my god. Yeah, so you can hug certain walls, but there's some other walls that simply don't do anything, so... Alright, come on, I need at least to try and see what the third room of this mess of hell is actually. That's right, magic carpet. I will vanquish you, whether you like it or not. So, yeah. I really don't know why there's some walls that you can touch into this game and some others which simply don't do it. Okay, come on. Oh, yeah. Because the bat is made... is put there in such a way that it takes the entire corridor. So, basically, what we're gonna do is... right here, we're gonna hightail this bat. Here we... oh my god! Wait, can you actually go through this thing? Nah, I'm pretty sure you can't. Knowing how this game works and all of this, so alright. We're gonna... oh no, there's no way I'm going through that. Alright, take your sweet time, bat. I'm not in a hurry because I'm certainly going to play a whole lot more of these games tonight. Oh my god, that was the most fitting of tributes. Maybe I shall actually do another video later on where I play actually good games for a change, because, well, yeah, unfortunately I'm not showcasing the Commodore 64 into its best light, but yeah, what do you know? This is what people probably will want to see anyway. Me trudging through the bad things. Alright, I'm gonna wait for this bat to come here again so that I'm gonna be able to hightail it. Okay, let's do this. Oh my, oh my god, I was so close, but alright, come on. Let's do this! Oh, there's no way I can fail this now. Oh, there's no way. There's no way. Hell yeah! Okay. Wait. Okay, I thought for 1 second that my Commodore 64 crashed, or at least... oh my god! Okay, I'm sorry, we're not gonna see the third part of this world. So, instead, we're gonna play Mind Control, another Mastertronic game. I'm pretty sure that, for some reason, I have managed to get every single game that these two guys have made, and... yeah. Oh my god. Yeah, so we're gonna play Mind Control, and we need to get into... yeah, watch out for the white blood corpuscles and the patients. And we also forgot the most important foe of the game, lamps! Yeah, jumping into a lamp kills you. So yeah, I'm not even sure if lamps or the patients which have turned blue is actually the bigger threat, and oh my god, I cannot climb a stair, so alright, I need to get a high score! So yeah, can I top myself? I surely can, because once again, this is one of those games that make you start with 1,000 points and make it so that instead of earning points by doing stuff, you lose points by simply existing. So what moral did these games taught us? Well, you are a loser by simply playing those games. Ah, Jesus Christ, the jump of your character is just wide enough, and sad to say, this is probably one of the better games that these guys have done. Yeah, what we're seeing here is the cream of the crop. Oh my god, can I actually pull this off? Yes, I can. Wait, I don't remember, is dropping through this is a handstand death? Yeah, it is. Because you can drop certain distances, but yeah, only a certain distance. Wait, can you actually kill yourself by... well, you can kill yourself by jumping down the stairs, but... Yeah, not in the way that you intended to. I was thinking for a second that maybe you'd be able to actually jump down the stairs, tumble down, and simply break your neck and spine. Jesus Christ, I'm jumping way too early here. Come on, gotta get to that brain so that we can actually kill this guy. For some reason, yeah. Our mission into this game is to kill a disembodied brain which is simply hanging there. And I also like how come they actually take the time to name everything. And yeah, by the way, isn't that an awesome jumping noise? Yes, we are small, and yeah, this is a highly detailed brain. And this is probably my favorite part of all of those Mastertronic games. So yeah, we're into the brain and we can shoot lasers, but we can only shoot it in order to kill the brain cortex here. Yeah, this is the biggest... Wait! Did the miniaturizing thing actually made all of your clothes cease existing? Because yeah, just notice what will happen whenever I'll die again, because this is a thing of beauty! And yeah, once again you die by simply touching the thing. And yeah, by the way, that's the only two levels that this game has. You have the brain, and once you when you manage to kill the brain, well, you actually go back here. But I'm gonna give it one last attempt because I actually want to kill this goddamn brain. And I don't even remember in what way this part of the game was made harder, because when you replay the other levels after that, the game do get more difficult, but what it makes is, well, all of the Jesus Christ, there was absolutely nothing I could do here. I was sandwiched between people who don't know how to walk and... Yeah, what the hell, they seem like they have a broken ankle or something, because one of their legs simply don't do anything. And once again, I was stuck into an impossible situation. Yeah, I gotta say those patients are really good, because they can walk with only one leg. But yeah, although I gotta say, at least the animation on the wheelchair dude is actually pretty neat. So Mr. Deuce Cass, okay, that's not actually where I need to go, so I gotta find where I was. So oh yeah, Mr. Cool, I think I remember this game also as being pretty neat in a way that really isn't. Yeah, this is Q-Bert, but without the graphical detail. So okay, how do I do anything here? Ah, here it is. Yeah, to hell with Q-Bert and his awesomely detailed sprite and him cursing whenever you die. That's where Mr. Cool is at, baby. At least, however, instead of cursing, he just melts through the floor, so I don't know. Maybe this is a neat alternative, but yeah, the actual game, however, kind of bites, and the later levels just get even more annoying, because I think just like in Q-Bert, you had to jump several times onto the platforms in order to clear them, and oh jeez. Aha! I am dancing in celebration of this event! Okay, no, this is another one of these into this level, the platforms just randomly decide whether they're... Okay, I had another life left, but I'm pretty sure this will be the last life that I'm gonna lead, because who the hell will actually want to spend their lives playing this game? Why am I doing... Okay, no, they don't actually revert the things, but instead... And that was Mr. Cool, ladies and gentlemen. Isn't that a pretty game? Oh, Mr. Robot, that is such a great game. Maybe I'm actually gonna play it for another video. Quasimodo... No, that's actually a good game, so... Oh, yeah, I know. I actually need to go back to this game. Some of you will probably... We probably viewed some of my other YouTube video will probably remember this game, because, well, I did do this game for some reason when I did a painkiller overdose video where I was just kind of making fun of the style of commentary. But hey, then again, it pretty much is the same kind of thing that I'm doing right now, so yeah, Quest for the Garden of Eden, made in 1983. So, okay. Wait. Why am I not walking? Okay, that's not the right button. Oh my god, yeah. I haven't played this game in a long while. But come on, I need at least to make it to this other stage. So yeah, that's how you beat this game. Yeah, you have to drop a whole bunch of... And this fucking fish is probably the worst part of this entire game, because... yeah, the moment that you spawn, you pretty much have to keep your trigger finger on the jump button or on the keys that allow you to do something. Oh god. And yeah, just in case that you wonder, the other levels get even worse than that. I made it all the way, I think, to level 2, but yeah. At this point, the game already gets unmanageable, and even just level 1 is already a huge feat. And by the way, there's absolutely no aim in trying to even do something as fancy than dropping rocks onto the baddies, because, hey, what it does is that basically, well, you... oh boy. Yeah, it do work in killing the fish, but hey, at least it's just, it's not like that he goes away for a pretty long amount of time, but alright, come on. Gonna get to level 2! Nothing stops the run of the Garden of Eden. Okay, the rock sound played for absolutely no reason, so... alright, we're gonna get that Garden of Eden! Whether you like it or not! I am gonna be invincible! I'm gonna dodge you fish! I will dodge everything that this game has in store for me! So yeah, isn't that great involving gameplay? Basically, this whole game is pretty much a work simulator or something, and yeah, by the way, don't drop rocks onto the bees, because all it does is to make the bee fly toward you, and basically, it can... come on, ah! Okay, but at least the entire pathway is clear now, so we're gonna be able to see the other level, baby! Okay, here we go. Yeah, I don't remember, however, what made this level harder than the other one. I suppose that I'll find soon enough. Oh yeah, the spider is a whole lot faster, but I thought there was another obstacle that made it even harder. Oh boy. Yeah, I really don't remember how to even make it through this level. In fact, I don't think I even beat this level before. Here is a clue for the adventure game. Beware of assassins. Okay, thank you. Is assassins the snake that killed me? But yeah, I really don't know. Quest for the Holy Grail. What is this game again? I completely forgot, so we're gonna learn together. Oh my god. Oh my god. Yeah, that's Monty Python, alright. Remember that one scene where the Monty Python guy just looked like a chicken? Quest for the... oh, ho, ho, ho. I see what those people have done here. This is really hilarious. Oh my god. Yeah, I don't remember playing this game at all, so maybe this is a... oh, an adventure game! Wait, so is there a hammer... hammering down a penis or something? Okay, visible... okay, you see... okay... alright, I suppose that I'm just going to make my... wait, it's a C and D nut. Okay, move C and D. Ah, Jesus Christ, I really hate those old adventure games. Ha, okay, here we go. I finally managed to do something into this game. Okay. I don't know what I'm doing here. Okay. I suppose that I need to actually do that. Okay, so what the hell was the point of that? What was even the... oh jeez, it actually has to redraw this whole thing. Okay. Alright, whoops. I'm not talking about the thing that I'm gonna slit whenever this video will be over. Oh my god. So, what exactly did it had to do with Monty Python exactly? I really have a huge problem imagining what this thing even is about. Okay. What? Okay, this game doesn't make any sense. So, yeah, is this supposed to be funny? Because, yeah, I'm not really sure. No, I'm not going through this again. So instead, we're gonna go through this again. Quo Vadis! From what I remember, there was some sort of contest, I think, with this game. And I think that the one contest basically is how long you can play this game without actually going insane. Or how long you can listen to the awesome soundtrack of this game. So we're into the dungeons, and basically, what? Yeah, you can go game over if you just climb back up. You refuse the challenge. Okay, what happened there? My guy just decided that he ceased existing. And yeah, by the way, I'm shooting right now, because even though the Commodore 64 has a fire animation, a fire button onto the joystick, basically, wait, what happened? Yeah, even though the, ah, Jesus Christ. And also, the second that there are enemies appearing into the screen like that, well, this humming or buzzing sound will never go away, so you better get used to that. But it's not as if we're gonna play this game for long anyway. But yeah, what did I wanted to say again before I was rudely interrupted by those villains? And yeah, by the way, yeah, the one way of noticing whether you're about to die or not is whenever your guy changes color. So yeah, I'm yellow, and after some time I'm gonna go purple and finally green. But yeah, what I wanted to say is that, well, a typical Commodore 64 controller will have a fire buttons, and all games are based around that. And yeah, by the way, I just fell down, and there's basically no... Oh jeez, now I'm turning yellow, so that means that I'm filling up with gangrene like crazy. Okay, can I actually go down here? I'm hoping that whatever I'm doing will have any kind of point. Because yeah, this game also has a whole lot of death pits and all sort of things out there. Ooh, this is very ominous. I'm getting chased by a whole bunch of butterflies while I'm shooting, because the people in this game weren't smart enough to code an action for a fire button into this game. Oh, a staircase! This game is innovative! Oh shit. And not jumping also is innovative, but I figured that since I fucked up my jump, I might as well... Oh yeah, by the way, all of the enemies into this game behave the same, and since the control... oh god, now I'm becoming green, I think I'm about to die, but I'm not really sure, because I don't think that there's a single time into this game where I died and it was due to damage or something like... Oh, okay, now I'm dead, because the game decided to. So, yeah, that was Quo Vadis, and yeah, that was a great game, alright. So, yeah, I figured that I'm about done with all of the list of games that I have rounded up for this little update that I'm doing right here. Just for the sake of it. So now we're gonna play Realm of the Undead, or Realm of Friendly Hulk, which is looking at you in admiration, because you've actually decided to undertake the journey through the Realm of the Undead. And yeah, this is a great game, by the way. I think my favorite part of this entire game is the really not loud footsteps that you're hearing. See if you can hear them, and see if you can also see the awesome hit detection of this game. Oh my god. Yeah, this game is dumb. And yeah, by the way, wait, can I actually climb down the floor? Okay, maybe I can. Oh, and yeah, by the way, those ladders, they're really finicky. You have to climb them exactly in the middle, otherwise it won't work. So now that we have our key, okay, I was thinking for a second, can I climb down the drawbridge? But unfortunately, it doesn't look as if we're here yet, but hey, at least the characters into this game have style, because of the way that this dog-like creature with the nightstick is moonwalking. A whole bunch of people like moonwalking because, well, oh, sorry, I was just too excited by this little fanfare which was playing, and what the hell is this thing? And, yeah. By the way, this is swan's. This is the swan leg, and yeah, this thing is supposed to be a swan or something. I don't know. Oh god, I'm drowning. Yep. He's so depressed, he doesn't actually want to fight his way up for oh my god, I died because my foot just touched the antenna of this little bug right here. This is a quality product that we have here. But it's not as if I'm allowed to whine too much because, well, I'm self-inflicting this pain upon myself. But come on, a fitting tribute, ladies and gentlemen. Even though, well, this man actually was a great man who actually made one of my favorite gaming platforms of all time. And yeah, it seems it's really, this song seems like the crossover between a fanfare, a Christmas tune, and something else. This is a potpourri of style. Alright, we're gonna get this key and we're gonna find a way across in order to get to this door. We're gonna go into the realm of the undead! This is Christmas music, but I am not playing this game because I fall in the acid, and this is what I want. Because this little coily, the spring, which is just going around here, Frankenstein is not happy to be here in the realm of the dead. Okay, I walked into fire, but supposedly it didn't kill me, so way to go, game. So, yeah, this is not the realm of the undead now, this is the realm of the... No! God damn it! Oh, Jesus Christ. Only because of ladder. Oh, jeez. And now because my character didn't walk too far here. But hey, at least it's really nice the way that he's melting on the ground. Oh, ass present. This is so fitting. Oh my god. Okay, come on. I need some relief before I actually go to the final stuff that I hear. Sea Fox is presented by an ass. But yeah, this is a game that I actually enjoy quite a bit, and we're gonna play it for some time. I don't remember what clone this was about, but this is a pretty pleasing game. Basically, you have to kill a whole... Sorry, I have to shut up for the impending music of this game, but yeah. Basically, what you have to do is to shoot torpedoes in order to kill the boats here, but you must not target the green boats with the arrows on them, because otherwise they're simply gonna bounce all of your torpedoes back at you, so this is a very bad thing. And yeah, by the way, you cannot surprise enemies from behind with your missiles, because, yeah. Because they're faster, mind you, but... We're gonna try at least to pull off some nice tricks, alright? Come on. Ah, Jesus Christ. Oh, God, no. I don't want to die the most horrible waiver. And yeah, we even get dolphins to refuel our submarine, too. This is the greatest game ever. And I totally mean that as no joke. Okay, that was a pretty close one, but yeah. That's kind of the crappy thing with this thing. You can only shoot one torpedo at a time. But, well, it's one torpedo of the horizontal variety, which you do by holding the fire button, and one of the vertical... Oh, jeez. I got surprised once again. I think I'm on my last life, and I... Still quite some wind on this game. The game gets pretty insane once you get into the later stages, but... Since the graphical capability of the Commodore 64 are kind of subpar, basically, as you go to the later levels. Yeah, sorry, I must never interrupt the music because this is the greatest thing ever. Ah, come on, I didn't even have a fanfare, but... Okay, great. Now I don't even remember what I wanted to say, which is fitting because I got game over. But yeah, because of the way that the graphical capability of the Commodore 64 handle, the game eventually crawls down to a slow speed, as you can see right here. This is what some of the later levels will look like, although, however, the CPU doesn't really do a good job at fighting the opposition, but hey, who needs to be good whenever you have God mode? So, what can we play now? Oh, yeah, that's right, that's another game that I need to showcase. The last of the Mastertronic series. 16 levels of ice cold, low pressure death. I gotta say, however, that line kinda sounds pretty neat, so... Yeah, this is Spacewalk, and this is a game I actually played a lot when I was a kid, because, well, I was a pretty dumb kid, what can I tell you? Oh my god, but... Yeah, at least compared to all of the other cheap, low-budget Mastertronic games, this is actually one of the ones that actually was the most fun, because actually it has more of a semblance of a game than any of the other games, even though it makes absolutely no sense whatsoever. And yeah, I'm doing pretty terrible right here, and I know at least that I need to get to the later stages, because the game do get pretty crazy into the later stages. So, just in case you didn't guess already, well, you need to carry the you need to carry the satellite. I was pretty much boned because, yeah, in order to finish any level into this game, you need to hold the satellite back into the launch pad, and it must not touch the ground whatsoever, because doing so, as I'm going to show you right here, is an instant game over, no matter if you have 3, 4, 5, 6, or even a million lives. If you destroy only one satellite, your journey is over. Which is pretty fitting for the low state of humanity right here. You can destroy how many astronauts that you want, but crush one- Jesus Christ, I died once again by being killed by an exploding planet. I mean, this is the craziest thing ever. And yeah, what is this? Is this the American flag? And holy shit, the flag on the right is the Quebec flag. Oh jeez, it now means that all of these people actually are French people, and this is putting a low blow on my heritage. Hélas, c'est vraiment pas une bonne chose. Oh boy. Okay, I gotta get the satellite here, because the music gets even better once you get to level 4, so at least I'm not gonna go to here. But yeah, this is something that you can actually do in order to gain some edge into the game. Yeah, that's right. This video is here for all of you that actually want advanced spacewalk tactics. That's right. Every single person out there on the internet will want to play this game whenever this will be really... Oh, come on, okay. Yeah, we've got an awesome noisy soundtrack here. Aphex Twin will be proud. Alright, come on. One last game of Spacewalk. You can never have enough Spacewalk. Nothing stops Spacewalk! Not even floor! Yes! Go over here, you little satellite. I'm... Oh my god, I shot through a planet and it didn't even explode. Okay, come on. I need to wait for my proper time. That's another bad thing whenever you're holding the satellite, because you need to be holding down the fire button, and fittingly enough, the fire button into this game allows you to shoot, but this is what having only one button on your key on your controller does for you. And this song is so soothing, considering that this is one of the harder levels that the game throws at you for quite some time, because those astronauts really are the worst. Because they're legitimately hard to avoid, but come on, I need to get back to the awesome noise concert that this game has. I'm not sure if there's any other games that I want to play after this one, so maybe this is a fitting end. But I suppose I'll see. I could still play another one or two games. We've went all the way here, so it's too late to stop. Okay, thank god. Actually, the hit detection on the satellite is pretty clement. Hello, Clement. My name is Psychedelic Eyeball. Okay, that was terrible. I'm sorry. But this is what having to listen to this soundtrack does to you. It turns your brain into mush. But it's kind of awesome in some way, though. I remember digging the soundtrack into this game. Yeah, once you get into this level, the soundtrack just goes into this utterly debilitated state. And well, this is awesome. It looks as if the soundtrack or the game itself is dying or something. And this is something that I can rally behind. The Commodore 60. Oh, Jesus Christ. I got ambushed from behind by the satellite. So, what could we play now? Oh, yeah, I know. I need to play this game. If only because that was another one of those games I used to play a lot when I was a kid. And we're talking about like 4 or 5 years old. I just remembered being hypnotized by this loading screen for some reason. But hey, come on. We had low standards back in the time. What can I tell you? So, alright. And yeah, this had a variety of gameplay modes. And basically, that was the most obtuse game ever because, yeah. Jeez, what? Oh, yeah, that's right. I need to be using the other gamepad to show. Okay, here we go. Now I can control myself. But yeah, what you had to do here is to shoot things. Yeah, hopefully not at you, but yeah, basically this is what you had to do. You had to shoot through all of this thing, and basically you had to collect all of your thing. Yeah, this game was kind of neat back in the time, but it's also the most incomprehensible mess ever at the same time. So, okay, nah, I didn't manage to surprise him. Okay. So basically what you have to do is to shoot a ball through all of this tunnel of deflectors and all of this, and basically you had to splat the computer into the face with one of your eggs, and that's easier said than done, as you're probably going to see. Basically, Jesus Christ. Yeah, that was another thing which made me love this game, the sound whenever you're dying, it's just so neat. Yeah, I remember being good at this game, and this is kind of scary because, holy shit, why would you want to actually have some kind of expertise here? Here we go, we finished level 1, and basically this is how it carries on. I don't even remember what evolved between levels. I think that there was more enemies to kill, but I'm not totally sure because I haven't played this game in a long while. But yeah, this game was kind of neat back in the time. And I'm putting the emphasis on kind at the time. And yeah, you also had your... okay, I thought for 1 second. Okay, alright, come over here. You have an appointment with an egg! Okay, or maybe you don't. Oh, jeez. And yeah, also, you kind of needed to get your eggs because, yeah, it will also try to shoot them at you, but don't worry, the computer doesn't have more tactics than you do. It's pretty much as blissfully ignorant of what's going on into this game. Oh shit, why did I do that? Oh! Ah! I can't believe that I'm actually getting nerves about this, but I think that in all of the games that I've played lately, this is probably the one that resembles the most of a game. I actually enjoyed this game back when I was a wee little lad. Right, one last time, just for good measure. Okay, first of all, I need to take this thing here. It's all coming back to me now. The awesomeness of this game, or maybe the fact that the computer... Alright. Yeah, this is gonna be an endurance run of this game just to see if I can get into a lengthy part of the game or anything. So. Oh yeah, I remember what attracted me to this game to begin with, but was there anything that changed into this game as you escalated levels? Because, oh yeah, that's right, now there's several enemies. Okay. Wait, what the hell? It came to a halt. So why did I die? Oh, and yeah, by the way, when you had blue things like that, whenever it came the time to shoot the... my foolproof strategy doesn't work anymore. Okay. Does it? Okay, I need to escape. Ah, okay. I guess you can also do this in order to kill the enemies, but... Okay, I'm running low out of eggs here, and this is starting to be a tense situation. Oh, shit. I was not in a position to shoot any eggs here. And yeah, that's Pitball. And... yeah, is there any other games that I want to play? I'm not too sure. Oh, Total Recall. That's a game I totally need to play at some point. Yeah, I'm not too sure if there's any other game that I want to play, so... I don't know, I think I need to actually finish this into... with a good note, so yeah. We're gonna go and play Wizard of War! A good old classic, yeah. We're gonna end this tribute with a proper thing that actually warrants a tribute. Or at least I'm hoping it does, because there's two versions of the game. And basically, one of them is kind of garbage and the other one is pretty much the most fantastic thing ever. So, I suppose that we're gonna learn. Alright, load the score. So, is this a oh yes, it's a good one. Yeah, that's how you do a soundtrack, and yeah, I totally fucked up my controls here because I keep forgetting what my keypad or anything is tied to, so... if I was multi-ambidextrial, I would be able to actually play like this, but nah, it's gonna serve as a decoy, so I think this is actually a good thing. But yeah, that was a really, really neat thing, and it's even better when you actually have someone to play it with. Basically, the one thing that really sold people into this game was the atmosphere, the thumping noises and all of this, and the soundtrack and everything. You do not need an elaborate soundtrack or anything in order to establish an ambience. Oh yeah, and also when you play on two-player, the game gets a whole lot easier for some reason. So, I suppose this is gonna be the final game of this update, so... well, of this update. I'm not too sure if I'm gonna make any other videos of this. Maybe I'll do some for games that actually matter for the Commodore 64, depending on whatever people actually are going to make their way through this whole video to begin with, but... hey, that's for the other people to decide, and... as far as I know, there's many worse ways in order to watch things on the internet. Yeah, come on, this is a whole lot easier when you play on two players. This is almost cheating. When you're playing on single player, this guy is totally up on crack and he goes at the craziest speed ever. And basically, you have to kill him before he exits the screen because otherwise you fail your chance at getting a high score. Oh jeez. I got surprised by the Pac-Man warp zone. And yeah, that's the arena, by the way. And there's another level, which is sort of in the same style, but instead, there's absolutely no walls, and this is basically the craziest level ever, because... well, walls are very important, because, well, you use them in order to kite enemies all around the place. Oh, jeez. Yeah, at least the enemies stick challenging through all of the game. Alright, come here, you slow gooder! Oh shit, the Wizard of War! And he died, yeah, basically that's the whole gist of him. If he touches you with one of his lightnings, well, basically, you lose your chance to killing him, so, yeah. Remember, being zapped to death, remember, results in you escaping. So basically, this is how the whole game goes. And at least it's fun enough to play for one or two rounds. So yeah, whenever this one playthrough of Wizard of War will be... I was too surprised by the fact that, well, I survived after clipping right through an enemy that I totally stopped paying attention to things. Okay, things are starting to be a little bit more menacing now. Yeah, the second that the other player had the opportunity to respawn, you saw that the warlock thingy actually started going a whole lot faster, and the moment that he finally was on the verge of respawning, it was like, okay, there's two players, it's time for me to stop, because I gotta be nice to my audience! People want to see me! Yeah, there's no more enemies once that you actually go there, but come on. What else did you expect from this game? It's one of those games where... Wait, is it me or I'm slower than usual out of a sudden? Maybe this is the sinister ploy of this game, so yeah, this is why okay. Yeah, that was not a good way to go. Yeah, even though I claimed that this was a whole lot easier with two players, I still didn't manage to go over really far. I didn't even make it, like, halfway through the game. So, there we go, folks. I suppose this is gonna be it for this homage to the Commodore 64, where we played a whole lot of games, a lot of horrible ones, and maybe one or two ones that I probably still will play today. So, I hope that you enjoyed this video, and well, I hope to see you again into another video of something. Goodbye.